I offer my humble pranam at the lotus feet of Bhagavan Sri Satya Sai Baba. In the last lecture, we have discussed about how to display message. Okay. So, in this lecture, we are going to talk about the binary search algorithm. Okay. Myself, Srinivas Shetty, Associate Professor in Department of ISE, DBIT, Bangalore. Okay, now this is the problem statement. What is the problem statement? Search a key element in a list of n 16-bit numbers using the binary search algorithm. I think all of you implemented this algorithm in C, C++, Java and all. But here, we have to implement this algorithm in assembly language. It's a little bit complex. Okay. Okay, what's the logic behind this? What's the algorithm for this? And actually here one important thing is what? Input must be
sorted
array. That is very important. Then what's the next one?
Eliminates
one half of the elements after
each comparison.
So locate the
middle
of the array. What is next?
Compare the
value at that location with
search key.
If they are equal,
done.
Otherwise,
decide which half of the array contains the search key.
Either you have to go for lower half or
higher half,
something like that. Then repeat the search on that half of the array and ignore the other half. Okay, the search continues until the key is matched or no elements remains to be searched. So this is the algorithm for binary search. Okay, we'll consider an example and we can analyze this particular thing. Okay, now just I consider an example. It's an array. Okay, just I'm going to explain for 8-bit number. In C, C++, we are not bothering about 8-bit or 16-bit. But in assembly language, that matters. Whether you're talking about 8-bit or 16-bit or 32-bit, that is very important. Therefore, here in general, I'm going to explain binary search. Okay, 8-bit is for 8-bit, something like that. Okay, what is this?
Array.
How many elements we have in this array?
13.
0 to 12, we have 13 elements. What is the name of the array?
Binary.
What is the name of the array?
A.
Okay, I want to search some element. Which element here?
19.
Okay. Then, what is the step number 1? First, we have to identify, it requires 2 pointers. Correct, na? As for our binary search, it requires 2 pointers. Which are those? So, pointer low pointer. That is one pointer. One more is what?
High
pointer. That is, this points to first element and this points to
last
element. So with the help of low and high, we have to find mid element. Mid. Okay. What is the value of mid here? Tell me.
Low plus high divided by 2.
See here, what is the value of mid here? Mid equal to
low
plus high divided by 2. What is the value of low?
0.
What is the value of high?
12.
Therefore, 0 plus 12?
12 by 2.
How much?
6.
That is 6 here. What is the mid value?
6.
Then, what is A of mid? What is A here?
Array.
Name of the array. What is the value of mid?
6.
What is the value of mid?
6.
What is the value of mid?
6.
A of mid? A of 6. What is the value of A of 6?
29.
Correct, no? Then compare this A of 6 with what? Search key. So what is the value of this value?
29.
Is it equal? No. Then what is the next step? Okay, we know that A of 29, that mid value is greater than? That is, 29 is greater than what? 19. That is a number to be searched. Okay. Now tell me, actually this is called a lower, this is called a what?
Higher.
Upper half. Okay, now tell me, whether 19 is available in the lower order or upper order?
Lower order
or upper order?
Lower.
Therefore, you have to ignore?
Upper.
Just look here. Okay, we know that. Middle of the array. This is the middle of the array. Compares A of 6, that is nothing but 29 and 19. 19 is smaller than 29, so that The next search will be used the which one?
Lower half of the array.
Okay, just here, it's something like this. See statement. If A of mid greater than key, tell me whether it's true or false.
True.
What's the value of A of mid? 29. Greater than?
19.
True. Then what we have to do? We have to adjust this pointer. Correct? Correct? No? Okay. That is I equal to mid minus 1. What's the value of mid?
6.
6 minus 1?
5.
Means we have to bring this pointer I to where?
5.
Here 5. See the next pass. See. Correct? No? Getting or not? In the previous case, this is the thing. And we are not supposed to consider this. That's why mid minus 1 na. Because this element is already compared, considered. Okay? Therefore, we have to bring this I pointer here. That is like 5. Okay. Now this portion. Lower portion. Once again, I have to repeat same thing. So once again we have low. Then once again we have high. Find mid. What is the value of mid here?
2.
2. Correct na? What is the value here? Mid. This is mid. What is the value of mid here?
15.
Now 15 equal to 19?
No.
15 greater than 19?
No.
Therefore, actually 15 less than?
19.
Now tell me whether 19 is available in lower or upper?
Upper.
Therefore, which pointer we have to adjust? Low or high?
Low.
Low equal to? Mid plus 1. What is the value of mid?
2.
2 plus 1?
3.
Therefore, the pointer has to be here. Correct, no? See, next. Correct, no? 3. Here, 4, 5. Okay, once again, repeat, same thing. Here, low. Here?
High.
Okay, I have to find the mid value. Mid equal to low plus high. Divided by 2. That becomes what?
4.
This is a 4. 4. 4. Once again, compare that value 25 with what? 19. Is 19. It equal?
No.
No. 25 less than 19?
No.
No. 25 greater than 19?
Yes.
Yes. Means what? What shall I do now?
Lower.
Whether you have to consider lower order or higher order?
Lower.
Lower order. Which pointer you have to adjust?
I
equal to?
Mid minus 1.
Mid minus
1.
Mid minus 1. What is the value of mid?
4
minus 1?
3.
Therefore, low, what is the value of low?
3.
What is the value of high?
3.
What is the value of mid?
3.
What is A of 3?
19.
Matched with?
Search key.
Equal or not? Yes, that is what? Found. Any doubts? Hello, any doubts?
No, sir.
Clear, no? Okay, this is the algorithm for what?
Binary
search. Therefore, how many pointers we require here? Low, I. With the help of this, you have to find
mid.
Compare that A of mid with what? Your number. Number to be searched. We can call it a search key. Okay, then if repeat this algorithm. Okay, if you have any doubts, you can contact on sairamassist@gmail.com. In the next lecture, I am going to explain about how to implement this binary search algorithm in 8086 assembly language. Thank you.